Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om.
Shaunaka said, O Sūta, thou art the most blessed and fortunate knower of the greatest truth. Out of great compassion, thou art narrating to us this divine, wonderful tale, Śiva Purāṇa. This wonderful narrative that destroys hosts of sins, purifies the mind, and propitiates Lord Śiva is being heard by us thanks to thy mercy. We have decisively realized that there is nothing so fine and nice as this epic. Who among sinners in the Kali age gets sanctified by this story? Please enlighten us. Make the whole world gratified. Sūta said, men who habitually commit sins, wicked persons indulging in vicious activities, and persons of lecherous disposition become pure hereby. This Śiva Purāṇa is a great jnana yajna, sacrificial rite of wisdom. It yields worldly enjoyment as well as salvation. It dispels all sins and delights Śiva. Men overwhelmed by the thirst of covetousness, those devoid of truthfulness, those who decry even their parents, haughty, vain fellows and persons prone to violent activities become sanctified by this. Those who never practice the duties of their varnashram, caste and occupation, and those of malicious temperament become sanctified thanks to the jnana yajna, even in the Kali age. Those who habitually practice deception, those of ruthless and cruel disposition, are sanctified by this jnana yajna, even in the Kali age. Those who misappropriate the wealth of brahmanas and thereby nourish themselves, and those who indulge in heinous crimes of adultery, become sanctified by this jnana yajna, even in the Kali age. Those who always indulge in sinful actions, and those who are roguish persons of evil mind, become sanctified by this jnana yajna, even in the Kali age. Men of unclean habits and wicked minds, men who know no peace, and men who swallow temple and trust properties, become sanctified by this jnana yajna, even in the Kali age. The merit accruing from hearing this Purāṇa destroys great sins, yields worldly enjoyments and salvation, and delights Lord Śiva. In this context, an ancient anecdote is cited as an example, the mere hearing of which removes all sins utterly. In the city of the Kiratas lived an extremely poor Brahmana, deficient in spiritual knowledge. His name was Devarāja. He used to sell various kinds of beverages and was averse to worshipping gods and virtuous activities. He never practiced the daily sandhya prayers or ablutions. His practice resembled a Vaishya's mode of living. He never hesitated to deceive credulous persons. He used to rob others, either by killing or by using various deceitful means. Thus, he later accumulated much wealth by foul means. But, sinner that he was, not even the slightest part of his wealth was utilized in virtuous acts. Once, that Brahmana went to a lake to take his bath. There, he saw a harlot named Shobhavati and was much agitated at her sight. The beautiful woman was extremely delighted on coming to know that a rich Brahmana had become her willing slave. The Brahmana's heart was filled with love due to her pleasant talk. He decided to make her his wife, and she consented to have him as her husband. Thus, in mutual love, they sported for a long time. Sitting, lying, eating, drinking, and playing together, they were not at all different from any other wedded couple. dissuaded again and again by his mother, father, first wife, and others, though he was. He never paid heed to their words, but continued his sinful activities. Once he became so enraged as to kill his mother, father, and wedded wife in the dead of night while they were asleep, and took possession of their wealth. Enamored of the courtesan, he handed over to her his own wealth, and also that he looted from his father, mother, and first wife. In the company of this harlot, he used to eat all sorts of forbidden food, became an addict to wine and spirituous liquors, and partook of his food from the same plate as his concubine. Once, by chance, he came to the city of Pratishtana. He saw a Shiva temple where saintly men congregated. He heard a discourse on Śiva Purāṇa conducted by a realized Brahmana. After a few days, he was afflicted by an acute fever. The Brahmana Devarāja died after a month. He was bound with nooses by the Yamadutas and forcibly taken to Yama's city. Meanwhile, Shiva's ganas, dressed in white, smeared with ashes all over the body, wearing garlands of Rudraksha and wielding tridents in their hands, started furiously from Shivaloka and reached Yama's city. They threatened the Yamadutas and thrashed them. Releasing Devarāja from the Yamadutas' clutches, they seated him on a wonderful aerial chariot. When they were about to start to Kailash, a great tumult arose in the middle of Yama's city, on hearing which Dharmaraj, the god of death himself, came out of his palace. On seeing the messengers, who appeared like replicas of Rudra himself, Dharmaraj, the knower of virtue, honored them in accordance with custom. Yama came to know everything through his vision of wisdom. Out of respect, he did not question the noble attendants of Shiva. Being duly honored and adored by Yama, they went to Kailash and handed over the Brahmana to Shiva, the very ocean of mercy, and to the divine mother, Parvati. Blessed indeed is the story of Śiva Purāṇa, the holiest of holy stories, the mere hearing of which qualifies even the greatest sinner for salvation. The great seat of Sadashiva is the greatest abode and the noblest position, which Vedic scholars have extolled as stationed above all other lokas. Devarāja, the fallen Brahmana, addicted to wine, enamored of a vile harlot, slayer of his own father, mother, and wife, and who, out of greed for money, had killed many innocent people, became a liberated soul instantaneously on reaching that supreme loka.